All right, I'm back on sculpting, and this time it's going to be a kind of something that doesn't happen often, but it does happen. I've gotten the wax from the mold of Ain't No Cowboy, and I'm going to be redoing the face for a client. Now, if they're willing to pay the extra to have something like that done, and it doesn't interfere with the piece's integrity, I don't mind doing a change here and there. This particular piece, he wants a face of somebody he knows, and this is her face here, and I'm going to attempt not to make an exact reproduction of her face, but using her face as the example of what he'd like on this face. Now, the reason I can't make an exact reproduction is means I would have to re-sculpt the whole face and reform the whole structure of the face. There's no way I can do that without... I have to keep a certain thickness, because all this is about an eighth of an inch thick. It's hollow. And they've cut away the brim of the hat so that I can see the face and work on it, and then they'll add that back on in the, you know, when I take it back to the foundry. What I'm going to try to do is smooth out her features a little bit, try to get as much of the features in these pictures onto this face, and work it out that way. The only other way you could do this is re-sculpt the whole face, go through the whole mold making process, and then have them make another wax. Now, that's way too expensive. I don't think the client wants to pay that much money. So, on top of the fact that they would be paying me extra for doing that much work. So, I do charge for making changes. And I think it's fair, only because it takes time from what I do every day. So let's get busy and see if what we can come up with. Now, I got to be real careful. I don't want to make the areas too thick with wax, because if I do, then when they cast it, some areas will be thicker than other areas. And if it's way too thick, it will start cracking in the bronze and distorting, because parts will cool differently than other parts. So, let's get started. Oh, first thing I need to do is clean my tools. So I'm going to do that, and I'll be right back. Okay, all the tools that I'm going to be using, I have to clean, because they had clay on them. And if I don't clean the clay off, that gets mixed in with the wax. And if you're going to go directly to a ceramic mold from this, that clay may cause problems. When they melt the clay, the wax out, it may explode or catch fire because of the oil base to it and stuff like that. I don't know. I also called up to find out, a lot of times I'll clean the surface or smooth the surface with lighter fluid. I called the foundry just now, asked them if I can take lighter fluid on a brush and smooth out the features that I'm going to be working on. And the foundry said there's no problem with that. Just let the mold or the guy working in the wax room know, so he'll know whether to clean off the surface of the clay or the wax or not, to get rid of the lighter fluid. But anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and get started here, and the first thing I'm going to do is start trying to figure out how I'm going to do this without losing the integrity of this sculpture. The first thing I'm going to do is change her mouth. Now, the foundry gave me strips of wax that matches the same kind of wax that they make the wax casting with. And so I've put it under a lamp to soften it, and now I'm going to start using this stuff. done with her. I've taken her as far as I can take her. Let's see a couple things here. There's a line right across here I gotta sort of get rid of. I've got as close to her face as I can get it without re-sculpting the whole dang thing. I'm going to use this Benzomatic. It's kind of like a torch to melt parts of her face, and I'm going to be very careful because I don't want to overdo it. And after I do this, and I'll go over it with the lighter fluid. Cool. All right, now I'm going to hit it with the lighter fluid. That's if I can find my brush. Now I use a painter's brush. And the reason I use a painter's brush is because it won't leave, oil painter's brush, it won't leave little hairs behind. Well, I'll touch this up a little bit more when I get to the foundry. I'll be in a different light there, and also have time to settle down a little bit so that I can make sure I got it just about right. All right, that's going to be it for today, and that's Ain't No Cowboy with a new face for this gentleman that is purchasing it. And to Erin, I hope your nose wasn't tickling when I was sculpting your nose today. That's the name of the girl that I'm sculpting from. Her name's Erin. All right, have a great day. I'll be going to the foundry tomorrow. I'm going to be recoloring a bronze, and I don't know if I'll show that, though. Well, actually, I will be showing that. And I'll be taking photographs of that piece afterwards for the client. They want a more traditional patina on a bronze that we just sold them. And so that's what we're going to do, is do that traditional patina. All right, until tomorrow, have a great night.